I'd been struggling for a while with different thoughts that I knew weren't quite right. And they were kind of taking over my day. They were really stopping me from being able to go out with my friends, socialising. I was stopping basically living a normal life. It was quite a scary time. I didn't quite know where to go. I was a bit lost.
The most common misconception of selective mutism is that you're choosing not to speak actually is caused by a biological factor, so you physically cannot speak. I was very lonely. I didn't have many friends. I used to play by myself. One question that you always get asked as a kid is, what do you want to be when you grow up? And I had no idea, because I thought I wasn't going to be anything because I had this disorder that meant I couldn't speak. For me, it seemed impossible that I would ever have like a job or friends or anything like that, any kind of semblance of a normal adulthood. Even as like a very young child, like maybe 5, 6 years old, I knew that.
I started experiencing low mood. I didn't ask for any help. I didn't know where to go to. I felt alone and I felt like no one really understood how I was feeling. I became disruptive in class. It was my way of speaking out.
I was referred to CAMHS at Alder Hey when I was just before my 16th birthday. I was terrified. It was completely new. I'd never spoken to anyone really about how I was feeling, about what was going on in my head. But as soon as I had my first appointment, I felt reassured, I felt safe. But I also, most importantly, felt listened to.
So I first spoke to teachers in school about my mental health and how I was feeling. CAMHS helped me be able to cope better with my feelings and notice that my feelings were okay and helped with my low mood.
I received some incredible help by a speech and language therapist. That help that I received changed my life, and Alder Hey truly gave me my voice. And now I want to use my experience to help give other people their voice too. I'm now studying to be a speech and language therapist myself at Newcastle University.
I'm now training to be a paediatric nurse. I'm really proud of myself that I've been able to use this experience to use it positively and not just allow it to consume me.
The help I received from Sefton CAMHS, it led me to want to be able to help other young people, especially in early intervention, because I think if I had have got that support early, then I might not have needed CAMHS. I think it's important to ask how people are, not just asking once, but asking twice how people are.
Try and look at yourself as a person who exists outside of your disorder. You're more than that. You have character beyond that. And I think that's something that's really important to remember.
It's just that taking that first step and being brave that then will allow you to get the help that you need. You won't feel like this forever.